pag nilayan po natin, importante dahil parang sinasabi natin sa the whole world, no, na 500 years na tayo na naging Christians. Yung nangyari, alam po natin, April 14, 1521, yung unang baptism. Gusto ko lang i-underline, no, yung una, yung relationship ng Santo Niño sa first baptism.
The image was taken to the Philippines by the Magellan expedition.
So it was given to Juana as a baptismal gift by Magellan.
Of course, lost for a time because of the unhappy ending of the expedition, rediscovered in 1565 with the Legazpi expedition.
Yung account na makita ni Legazpi, nagpasalamat sa Diyos na para sa kanya ito na yung reward, no, sa hardships nila.
The finding or the common Cebuano term of that is kaplag, pagkakaplag, is the finding of the Santo Niño's image in 1565. Right after that, it ignited the love, or I mean the zeal of the missionaries to evangelize the country because they found a reason to continue the Christianization. Hence, the role of the Santo Niño is very important historically because this very devotion was used by the missionaries to introduce the faith to the people.
Pero the most important event doon is since then naikwento na it united both the Spaniards and the natives.
But today, 92% of us are Catholics. We practice probably folk Catholicism, which is a mixture of indigenous native practices and Catholic practices.
It was eventually given and entrusted to the Augustinian friars, who at the same time were present in that expedition because they were the ones in charge for the formal evangelization of our country in 1565.
Now, when did this strong devotion begin? In the 1921 event, the 400th anniversary, it's recorded that there was a celebration at the Basilica, but hindi siya ganun ka-laganap na ka-spread all over. It started, I think, in 1965. During the 400th anniversary of the evangelization of the Philippines, yung 400th anniversary ng arrival ni Legazpi, when there was an international conference, international event, and there was a 1-week-long series of events, including the first sinulog contest. Because sinulog used to be like caroling in house to house in 1965. And then in 1981, lumabas yung sinulog festival with a grand parade. That created a whole event that internationalized and created a whole body of celebrations for the whole week. So, 1965 and the 1981 Cebu Festival when it started.
Kung may nakikita po tayo na mga reasons why bakit malapit sa Pinoy ang Santo Niño devotion, they accepted the faith and they allowed the faith to have a meaning in their lives.
Before God, we should believe that like a loving parent, no? At bata tayo, hindi niya tayo pabayaan, no?
It is always an observation to us as Filipinos that we love children, no? And because in our love of the presence of children in the family, kaya ang ano natin, yung attention natin, yung pagpapakita natin ng pagmamahal is always with the children.
And if in the Bible, because of sin, yung mga tao natakot sa Diyos, when God reveals Himself as a child, yung dating ba, hindi tayo natakot sa bata, no? Yung ninyo kasi attractive, no, guwapo, yung cute, no? Instead na matakot tayo, parang we're drawn, no? Na lumapit.
Na malapit sa kanyang puso, madaling puntahan, madaling hingan ng mga padalangin. And so, the natural ability of the person to connect with the child.
At dahil nasa siya bata, at dahil nasa yung inaawit natin na batubalanin sa gugma, like a magnet, he draws us to himself. As the expression suggests, the batubalanin is a magnet, no? It draws us to him. No? Kaya nga yung attitude ng Filipino, pag nakita mo yung bata, hindi ka umatras na, yung lumalapit ka sa bata. At yun din yung pagtingin ko dito na yung minibus the Niño unites famous people hindi mo wala yung mga away-away, pero in general, it brings unity to the country.